Dear students of standard 12, we are going to start the new topic. I said it is applications of biotechnology. Already we started this class and the video classes are already sent to you. In that video classes, in the introduction of biotechnology, applications of biotechnology in the field of medicine, that is first one, recombinant human insulin, recombinant human growth hormone 8, human blood clotting factor 8, interferon, recombinant vaccines, then gene therapy and stem cell therapy. All the things we have already completed in the video classes. So the above technologies are taught in the video classroom video classes. Now the remaining part of the same topic, applications of biotechnology, there are so many other techniques are there which we are going to study in this PowerPoint class. So the next topic after this is molecular diagnosis. First we have to know what is the meaning of diagnosis. By lab testing we have to identify the type of infection or the problems present in the body, that is called a diagnosis. Say whenever we are having some problem, doctors may ask us to take blood test, or the doctors may ask us to take urine analysis, like that. So that is called to find out certain problem in the body, to find out certain infections in the body, that is called a diagnosis. Is there any defect in the individual's body? Molecular, that means the diagnosis is based on molecular level. It may be the microscopic organism, or it may be the toxic substance produced by the microorganism, or the DNA. DNA is a macromolecule. So up to the DNA level, we are identifying. That is called a molecular diagnosis. We will take the meaning of it. Diagnosis. First, we have to know what is the meaning of diagnosis. Detection. That is finding out of infections. First, any microorganisms entered into the body, we have to find out. Defective functioning of tissues. We have lot of tissues in our body. Whether any tissues are not functioning properly, that is called a defective functioning of tissues or organs. Sometimes the heart may not function properly. It is a defect in the heart. Kidneys may not function properly. Kidney problem. Lungs may not do their functions properly. Lung problem, like that. Organs. Defective functioning of organs. Sometimes we are finding out genetic disorders, whether any genetic problem is present, whether any defects are there in the genes. That is called a genetic disorders, etc. In the medical labs. Now we cannot do this in every lab. Only the hospitals are having medical lab. In the medical labs we are doing a lot of tests. This is called a diagnosis. So the whole thing is for the meaning of diagnosis. So diagnosis is the detection of infections, defective functioning of tissues and organs, genetic disorders, etc. in the medical labs is called a diagnosis. Okay. Conventional diagnosis. In the diagnosis, two methods are there. One is conventional, old method. The second one is advanced method, that is modern methods. Now first we are taking conventional diagnosis. That is long time before. Now these are the technologies which developed about 30-40 years before in the field of medicine, that we are calling it as conventional diagnosis. What are conventional diagnosis? Microscopic examination. For example, little blood they will take, they will keep it under a microscope, they will search for the cells or any infections or anything. That is microscopic examinations. Serum analysis. Serum means actually blood. Okay. Blood analysis. Whether in the blood glucose is present normal quantity or more quantity, RBCs are in right number or less number. Now all these things are serum analysis. Urine analysis, etc. Sometime what will happen, they will take the sample, urine as a sample, and they will try to analyze in the urine whether any glucose is there or any infectious microorganisms are present in that. That is urine analysis, etc. All these things are old method, conventional diagnosis. Now, early detection is not possible in the conventional diagnosis. That is sometime what will happen, before the individual is suffering, we have to find out the problem. But in the conventional diagnosis, it is not possible. Okay, early detection is not possible in conventional diagnosis because this method is done only after the development of symptoms of the disease. For example, we are having high fever. Okay, shivering is there. Okay, and also we are finding it a heavy headache. Now we are going to doctor. That means what? The condition of the severity of infection is more, so that we are getting lot of symptoms. Then we are going to doctor. Doctor is telling, okay, go for blood check for malarial parasites, whether they are present. So when they are diagnosing it, the condition of or the severity of the infection is very high, so that early detection is not possible because this method is done only after the development of symptoms of the disease. By this time the problem becomes severe. By the time the problem is already severe, so the suffering will be there, the individual has to suffer. Okay, after that only they will diagnose it, then they will give treatment. Maybe after 3 days or 4 days or 5 days the particular problem will be solved. Okay, example, infection, microorganisms are entering, that leads to the symptoms. That means what? Already they are multiplying, they are causing problem, symptoms are developing, symptoms. Then after that only we are diagnosing. Okay, it is called a late diagnosis. Now we are coming to advanced diagnosis, the second method I told. Only two methods, old method, new method. Old method is called conventional, the new method is called what? Advanced diagnosis. Now what are the advanced diagnosis we have to say? That is rDNA technology, recombinant DNA technology we will do. That means we are going to the DNA level, DNA of the microorganism. Microorganism means maybe bacteria, viruses, or they may be even infectious or parasitic, fungi, etc. Or DNA technology is the first method. Second one is polymerase chain reaction. Okay, polymerase chain reaction. This only they are calling it as very shortly PCR test. Okay, now this name PCR test is very very popular because very recently, about 6 or 7 months before, the pandemic was there. That is corona. So for testing whether the person is having coronavirus or not, they used to do this PCR test. The expansion for PCR is polymerase chain reaction test, PCR test. The next one is ELISA test. It is abbreviation ELISA, ELISA. That is all the letters must be capital letter because it is a abbreviation, ELISA test. Now these are the tests which are considered as advanced tests because they are molecular level, and also before the individual is suffering we can find out whether the individual is having the microorganism. Note, early detection is possible by advanced diagnosis. Early we can do, can detect the presence of nucleic acid of the microbe. Not necessary that we have to find out whether microbe is present or not. Okay, we can find out whether the DNA is present. That is only what your nucleic acids. Nucleic acids means DNA and RNA. Anyone. DNA we can identify. If DNA is not identifiable, RNA we can identify of the microbes as soon as they enter. For example, today the microorganisms enter. Today itself we can identify, or tomorrow itself we can identify. Before the symptoms develop, we can identify their presence. That is the importance of advanced diagnosis. Now we are coming to ELISA test. This ELISA test, they started long time before, maybe about 20, 30 years, 40 years before they started. Now we'll take this ELISA. What is the expansion for? Enzyme linked immunosorbent assay. Assay means analysis. Assay means analysis. Enzyme linked immunosorbent assay, that is the test. Now what is the use of this ELISA test? We have to see, it is useful for detecting the presence of specific antibody. Whenever microorganism is entering inside, our body is producing antibody. Our blood is producing antibody. Okay, sometimes the virus may be very small, we cannot identify. with the help of normal microscopes we cannot identify. But what we can do is, once the virus enters, very next moment our blood is start producing antibody. So we can take little amount of blood and we can see whether antibody for that particular microorganism is present. So that is called detecting the presence of specific antibody for the whole of microorganism. Micro, for the entire microorganism, one antibody will be produced. Example, presence of HIV is identified, that is by the analysis of antibody in the blood. So this antibody is called HIV antibody. When HIV is entering, our blood is producing antibody. That antibody is called what? HIV antibody. So what, with the help of ELISA, we can identify the presence of HIV antibody in the blood. If HIV antibody is a present, virus is present. If HIV antibody is absent, the virus is not present. That is the meaning. Also, detecting the presence of specific antigen microorganism, we can identify. Suppose it is virus, means very difficult. But if it is a bacterial cells, we can identify. Microbe, we can identify. Or toxin produced by the microorganism. The toxin means poison. The poisonous substance produced by the microorganism. Even this also we can do. One is, that is identifying the presence of HIV antibody. Also detecting the presence of specific antigen. Antigen is a microorganism or the toxin. Now there are four types of ELISA test. There are four types of ELISA test. Any one method will be followed. Okay. Now, the doctors know very well which type of the method we have to follow. One is a direct ELISA, indirect ELISA, sandwich ELISA test, competitive ELISA test, are the four types of ELISA tests. Now added advantages of this ELISA. What are the added advantages? One is, very early we can detect the problem. Added advantages. No need of radioactive isotopes. Radiations are not necessary for this test. Only little amount of sample of blood, we can identify everything. Now radioactive isotopes are not necessary for that. Sometime we are going for x-ray, we are going for scan and other things and all. But all these things are having radiation, they may cause some side effect. But here no side effect at all. No need of a radioactive isotope. And counting chambers, blood cell counting chambers and all, not necessary. Now the steps involved in ELISA test. Now how they are doing the test, we have to see. Well, little amount of blood is enough. Maybe a few drops of blood enough to test this. Now procedure for ELISA test. Now actually this diagram is not there in the textbook. I have drawn for your easy understanding. Now we are taking a microscopic slide, glass slide we are taking. It is a clean and sterilized one. Then we are taking a drop of blood. One drop of blood we are taking. Okay, this is the blood sample. Now the blood what we are taking from the person is called a blood sample. Okay. Now in the blood sample, I assume that there are microorganisms, okay. Now a number of microorganisms are present. The black big dots are called antigen. Antigen means microorganisms are present. Okay. Now the blood is there, microorganisms are present. Then what we have to do in the step one, pouring antibody suitable for that antigen. Antigen is microorganism. Now what we have to do, already we prepared the antibody for that. Now we have to pour little amount of, maybe one drop of this antibody which is suitable for this antigen. For every microorganism, one specific antibody will be present. That specific antibody we have to put it. Now the antibody, the small dots what I kept. Now all these things are antibody. So the antibody and antigen, okay, they are present together. Right. In the next slide, this is the next step. What is happening? Step 2 in that subdivision A. Now this is the slide. Now blood is there. Now we are having antigen. We are pouring, what is that? Antibody. The antibody reacts with antigen. We have to leave for about a few minutes, maybe 2 minutes or 3 minutes. Then at that time, the suitable antibody is reacting with antigen. When these two are reacting with antigen, then agglutination is formed. What is the meaning of agglutination? The microorganisms are clumping with each other, sticking with each other. That is called agglutination. Okay, when the antibody is reacting with the antigen, both are suitable, then all the microorganisms are sticking. they are patch after patches you can find. That means in each patch one group of microorganisms will be there. They are sticking with each other. That is called agglutination of microorganism. For this, what we are doing is we are pouring hydrogen peroxidase. One enzyme is present. In the presence of this enzyme only, antibody can react with antigen. We are pouring hydrogen peroxidase, then their reaction is taking place, then agglutination is taking place, the clumping is taking place, the microorganisms are sticking. Okay, the next one, the same thing. Step 2A is pouring this, what is that? Hydrogen peroxidase. But in the next one, B, 4-chloro-naphthol, one reagent is present, coloring agent. Reagent means coloring agent is there. What is that name of the chemical? 4-chloro-naphthol. Naphthol. Now this 4-chloro-naphthol reagent is poured here. Now what it will do, the clumped microorganisms are there, they will absorb the chemical, reagent, and they are becoming one particular color. Okay, beautiful color will be formed. Now the agglutination, clumping, the agglutination becomes colored. It may be pink in color or red in color or purple in color, some coloration will be there. If the coloration is a formed presence of microorganism, HIV is present. Now suppose the clumping is not taking place, agglutination. There is no color formation. Even after pouring this chemical, no color formation. What we can understand is no HIV, no microorganism. So they are not clumping with each other. Now this is the meaning. If the coloration is formed, agglutination takes place. Two things we have to say. Agglutination must take place, then coloration should appear, then HIV is present. If these two are not there, agglutination is not there, then coloration is also not found, then HIV is not present. Overall, for this testing, it will take 5 to 10 minutes. Within 5 to 10 minutes, they will give the report whether the individual is HIV positive or negative. That is ELISA test. Now we are coming to PCR test. Already I told polymerase chain reaction test, PCR test. Now we will take, this is in vitro amplification technique. In vitro, anything which we are doing artificially in the laboratory, it is called in vitro. Okay, we are doing this in the lab, that is called in vitro. This is in vitro amplification technique. This technique is useful for amplifying certain things, increasing certain things. That is called amplification, that is a technique used for the synthesis of multiple identical copies of DNA of our interest. Now we are having some DNA. We have extracted one DNA from one organism. Now this DNA, only one copy we have, because we have taken from one microorganism. But we can multiply the DNA, many copies, enormous number of copies, maybe 100, 200, 300 copies we can do. So since the single DNA and many copies are produced, it is called amplification technique. So this is the in vitro amplification technique used for the synthesis. Synthesis means production of multiple identical copies. Identical, same type of DNA, identical copies of DNA, of our interest. Which DNA we are extracting, that is the DNA of our interest. Three steps are involved in PCR test. Three steps. The first one is called denaturation. Naturally the DNA is present, but we are separating them. That is called denaturation. The DNA is separated into two strands, primers. Each strand is called one primer. In the 11th standard, you might have studied DNA is a ladder-like structure. This ladder-like structure is having two frames. One frame at the center here, one frame here. Between that, a number of steps will be there. That is called a DNA molecule. It is a long chain. The two frames are called strands. So always the DNA is a double strand. Double strand means two frames will be there. The DNA, the two strands of DNA are separated. So the DNA is separated into two strands. Each strand is called primer. So primers, two primers are formed. Then the second step is renaturation. Now what is the meaning of this renaturation? We have to see. Renaturation. It is also called primer annealing. see the spelling for that, ANNEALING. Don't pronounce this as annealing, annealing, okay? Then each primer, okay, each strand, is there, no, is a hybridized, that means it is joining with new combination of DNA. This each strand is a hybridized with another one primer, okay, another one new primer, so it is becoming hybridized, okay. Then this is called, now what is the meaning of annealing? It is given here down, I'll tell you. The third step is synthesis. Synthesis means production or primer extension, okay. The primer is elongating, primer extension. Now we'll take the primer template. Template means the original copy of the primer is used to synthesize many copies. One original primer we have, okay, that is a strand which is separated. Now from that, enormous number of copies will be produced. Many copies of extended DNA will be produced. That is actually called a synthesis or primer extension. Note, annealing. What is the meaning of annealing? Any chemical in the laboratory, rapidly it is heated. The temperature is quickly increased, enhanced. Okay, rapid heating and slow cooling. Okay, it is called what? Slow cooling. I'll tell one example for annealing. Suppose we have an iron rod. Okay, we are keeping in the strong fire. Okay, we are introducing one tip into the strong fire. So within 5 minutes or 10 minutes, if you take the tip of the rod, iron rod will become red hot. Okay, very quickly it is becoming very, very hot. That is called rapid heating. Okay, that iron rod with the tip which is reddish, you know, that is, we are keeping it little away. We are allowing it to cool down automatically according to the natural surrounding temperature. But the cooling will not be rapid cooling, it will be slow or gradual cooling. That is called a slow cooling. The same way, some chemicals in the laboratory, what we can do is, we can heat very faster, but we are allowing the chemical to cool down slowly. That is called annealing. So when we do this annealing, okay, already we have given that. Now renaturation, primer annealing, that is each strand is hybridized with a primer. So how it is attaching with the new primer? Rapid fast or rapid heating and then allowing it to cool very slowly. At that time the new primer will come and join with the old one, okay. That is the meaning for annealing. Now we are going to take about the steps involved in PCR test, okay. Now this is one strand, what is that, segment of DNA. Now it is kept horizontally. Now actually ladder is vertical. Now we are keeping it horizontally. One small fragment we are taking. This is one frame. This is another one frame. Each frame is called one strand. So here one strand is there, here one strand is present. Between that the steps are there, that is only green color. The steps are made up of nitrogenous base pairs, okay, nitrogenous base pairs, okay. Denaturation takes place first. What is the meaning of denaturation? We have studied the two frames are separated. Now this frame is going here, this frame is coming here. Now when they are separated, what happened to the central steps? All are broken into pieces. Now see the pieces, okay. Now they are all nucleotides. The small pieces are called what? Nucleotides. Nothing but paired nitrogenous bases. Now they are separated. Okay, denaturation is over. Now we are coming to renaturation, otherwise called what? Annealing. Okay, now for denaturation we are requiring 95 degree C temperature. In the high temperature they are separated. Okay, denaturation is over. Then this is one frame, next to one frame is there, but a new primer is coming and joining here. Similarly here also one new primer is coming and joining, okay. Now that is called annealing. How this is possible? Already rapidly heated, now gradual cooling is taking place. At that time the new primer is coming and joining here. Now this is called a hybridization. This also called a hybridization. Then after that only one I'll take. Now this is the frame. Now already the hybrid primer is coming, then it is extending completely to become a new ladder. Like that, this side also it is becoming one new ladder. Original prime is there, frame is there, strand is there, one new strand will be formed here. So two copies will be produced. Now the same, now for that again 75 degree C is required, okay. Now this we have to do it repeatedly a number of times. Then enormous number of copies will be produced. That is actually called a PCR test. Now little more, the same PCR, little more explanation is given in this picture. Now this is the DNA. Okay, two frames are given. Now two colors. This is another one for giving little more information. Now here you can see that steps. The white region is completely, a lot of steps are present. First is what? That is denaturation. That means what? The frames, the two strands must be separated. Now this strand is coming here separately. This strand is coming separately here. Okay, now see the two color. Now each strand is called a primer. Okay, each strand is called a primer. Okay, now original primer, original strands they are. Okay, then after that, what this primer is doing in the renaturation. Okay, now this is the original primer. One new primer is coming and joining. This is synthesized. It is synthesized and it is forming. So this is already one strand. Now one more new strand is formed. So again it is becoming a ladder-like structure. Same way here also. This is original primer. One new primer is coming. Strand is coming and joining. Then a ladder is formed. So two. Now see that first one for separation. Heat, cool. Add primers to get SS DNA. Single strand, SS means single strand DNA that primers anneal to. That means this is one strand, this is another one strand. Here one primer is coming and joining, here also one primer is coming and joining. Now that is the first step, denaturation. Naturation, renaturation. In that, add tag, TAQ, tag polymerase, one enzyme. With the help of that enzyme only, the new strand will be synthesized. Okay, now these are all the nitrogenous bases which are there to synthesize complementary strand. Now this is original, this is complementary. A complementary strand will be formed. Like that, this is original strand, a new complementary strand will be formed with the help of this tag polymerase. Okay, right. Now repeat the cycle 25 to 75 times. Now one time, one strand is becoming two now. Now again you are doing the same way repeatedly, then you can find enormous number of copies will be produced. Several hundreds of copies will be formed. That is polymerase chain reaction. It is a chain reaction like.